So hey guys, before we get started with the main commentary on this video, I just want to let you all know that Black Ops 3 is currently featuring a double XP weekend as of right now. They also just started a new community contract where we have to get 500 million headshots again in either zombies or multiplayer in order to unlock the cosmic camouflage. It's weird to say that because this camo was provided absolutely free yesterday, and then they ended up taking it away, and then today, now we have a challenge in order to unlock it to earn it back. And to put insult to injury, this is the only reward we get. So in between getting all of those little tiers, there's no calling cards, no emblems, anything of the sort. So the only thing we can earn for 500 million headshots is the camouflage. But anywho, let's move on to the conversation of the season pass. We all know that the season pass has been pretty much the same for Call of Duty over the past 5 years. If we really want to get technical, 6 years with the Call of Duty Elite membership. Remember that with Modern Warfare 3 where the maps would release like every single month? That was kind of cool. I liked that idea, and that was a different way to do the season pass. But after that, it's been focused on 4 DLC packs, and these packs contain 4 multiplayer maps, and then of course we have that bonus mode. So Treyarch has zombies, Advanced Warfare had zombies, Infinite Warfare has zombies, and Ghost had Extinction. So, but the one thing that I've also noticed as a player of Call of Duty, there are 2 complaints that people have, at least for the past 3 years. The first one being, man, the supply drop system sucks. And the second one being, why can't I find a lobby? Man, is this game dead? I can't even get into a game of Team Deathmatch. And most of these questions that we ask ourselves happen towards the end of the year with DLC 4 being released, and that's because the community is just completely broken up. Think about it this way. If you get the DLC from the season pass, you get everything. You get all 4 map packs. But if you're someone who can't afford the season pass at the time, maybe you just don't feel like getting the season pass because you don't like playing the multiplayer maps that much, and you just pick and choose which ones you want to get, you can purchase 1, 2, 3, or 4 of the map packs individually. You can get just the 3rd map pack or just the 4th map pack or just the 1st one or just the 2nd one. So then when you go to find a lobby, and let's say DLC 2 map pops up and you're the only one sitting there like, okay, where is everybody? There has to be a certain amount of people online playing at that specific time with that DLC map in order to get placed in that lobby with you. I mean, there are so many different variables. For example, too, the servers even matter as well, because not often, if any time this happens anymore, will you get linked up with somebody from the UK if you're from the United States, unless you invite somebody from the UK to play with you? Or, for example, you'll get linked up with somebody from China if you're playing. Like, back in the past, yes, that's something that would happen quite often, but I don't even see that anymore. But what I'm trying to say is, it would be in the best interest for Activision just to change the DLC model and give everybody the map packs for free. At least provide that. Now let's switch gears and talk about the supply drop system. Black Ops 3 is the most infamous game for the supply drop system because of just how many weapons and melee weapons the game has. I believe there are over 40 ranged and melee and special weapons available after the fact that the game came out. Black Ops 3 has more DLC weapons than actual base weapons that came with the game, and that is not good. Now, looking at this specific model and moving forward, of course, Infinite Warfare did it right, providing the weapons for free with the season pass. But that doesn't mean that they wouldn't go back to this old model, right? That doesn't mean that they wouldn't want to make more money with a more popular game. And I think World War II, looking at you, you're probably going to be more popular than Infinite Warfare. So what if they did go back to this old model like Treyarch had with Black Ops 3? And instead of actually just betting it all on luck, what if instead of a regular season pass, they offered a weapon season pass? Like, would you actually be willing to drop $50 on a season pass instead of DLC? You would get weapons? Because if that were the case, I would do it in a heartbeat, personally speaking. I can't speak for everyone on this, but I'm just saying, if there was a weapon pass to where any new weapon would come out, you would immediately have it the very second it releases if you had this weapon pass. Would you do it? Would that be a better alternative than spending money on supply drops or just risking it all with your crypto keys or whatever to have the small chance of actually obtaining it? I would want to be guaranteed that weapon. And if they don't have the same exact, I guess you would say, model that Infinite Warfare has, then things are going to get a little bit crazy and hectic. Now, I'm not saying that this game with World War II is going to end up like that, because as of right now, we don't know much, if anything, about the season pass for World War II. They can actually change it. In fact, here's an image that came out not too long ago. This actually came from GameStop, I believe. And down at the bottom, you can see that there is a small fine print talking about the season pass, and it says, "Season pass purchasers receive 2018 Call of Duty World War II season pass content. Season pass content is not final and is subject to change. It may not include all downloadable content available for the game." And that is in reference to weapons, character gear, things like that, of course, so they can put a supply drop system in the game. And I'm sure something like this exists, and I'm sure we'll learn more about it next week, but the thing is, it gets me really anxious, you know what I'm saying? Like, it makes me think about what they could possibly do in regard to weaponry. We know that there is a ton of weapons that existed with World War II, and if they wanted to, they could hold off on a few of those and add them into a supply drop system later on down the line. So for me at least, if they were to take away the standard season pass, give us all of the DLC map packs for free, and have only a $50 season pass specifically for weapons, I would pay the extra $50 specifically just for the weapons to have them all unlocked on day one right away for me to use at the get-go. But I'm not really sure what to think at this point. But let me know your thoughts down below in the comments section. I think the season pass definitely needs to be changed, and if the same DLC model from Infinite Warfare isn't with World War II, then things are going to get a little bit crazy. If you guys enjoyed the video here today, enjoyed the conversation, click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, my friends, I will see ya. Peace.